Obeying the Gospel, June 14th. Assurance that Jesus will be our judge. Because he has fixed a day on which he will judge the world in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed, and of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. Acts 17:31. Concerning God, the ideas of accountability and judgment are not congenial to the modern mind. Those who believe there is a God do not usually think in terms of being judged by him, such that their eternal destiny will be dependent on that judgment. Yet God's judgment is one of the things affirmed about him in the Scriptures. Consider the text in Acts 17:16-34. In this passage, there is the account of Paul's presentation of the gospel of Christ in Athens. Invited to speak to a group of philosophical inquirers, Paul talked first about the nature of God as a personal creator, and then he spoke of God's judgment. A time has been appointed, Paul said in verse 31, when the world will be judged by God, and this will be done in righteousness, which is to say, God's verdict will be exactly the right verdict in every case, rendered in perfect justice. What is more, Paul said that God has entrusted this judgment into the hands of a man whom he has appointed. This is Jesus Christ, and of this God has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. The resurrection established the truth of many things, not the least of which is Jesus' deity, his identity as the Son of God. But Paul shows that Christ's resurrection also verified his role as the one before whom we must stand in judgment. If someone wanted proof that judgment is coming and that Jesus will be the judge, no greater proof would be possible than his resurrection. This, then, is one of the Messiah's roles. In addition to being our high priest and king, he is our judge. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself, and he has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man, John 5:26 and 27. For those who have accepted the gospel faithfully, the coming judgment holds no fear, only love. But one way or the other, judgment is coming. Of that, we may be sure. On Acts 17:31, F.F. Bruce commented, Paul does not refer directly to the human figure, the one like a son of man, of Daniel 7:13. But this is the man whom he has in mind, the one in whom God's eternal purpose finds its fulfillment, the one to whom the Father has given authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man, John 5:27.